Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our first time single take honest reaction to Astronomy of Metallica. It's a request of our patron Ajay. By any chance have you heard it? Astronomy? No? Then it is a first time for both of us.
Yeah, I've not heard that many Metallica songs, no? Less than 10, and what we have reacted
to.
Yeah, probably 15 to 18, 20 songs totally I may have heard.
Mm-hmm.
All that we have reacted to and one or two more apart from that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so this I have not heard. I don't even know which album it is from, which era of Metallica it is from.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's get started. Obviously, the topic is one which we have heard two or three bands or artists with the same or similar title.
Yeah.
One being Blue Oyster Cult, one being Ginger, and now Metallica. I'm not sure this is a cover or an original or theirs was a cover original.
Uh-huh.
Not sure at all. Let's listen to it for our patron Ajay.
Strikes 12 and moon drops burst out at you from their hiding place. Like acid and oil on a madman's face, his reasons tend to fly away. Like lesser birds on four winds, yeah, like silver scrapes in May. And now the sands become a crust, and most of you have gone away. Susie Dale, let's take a walk, just out there upon the beach. I know you'll soon be married, and you want to know where winds come from. Well, it's never said at all on the map that Carrie reads. Behind the clock back there, you know, at the phone's bar.
Came me.
This sounds a little bit weird and complicated on the first listen.
Yeah, it does.
It's one of the weakest songs of Metallica I've heard. One of the weakest.
Written?
One of the weakest songs I've heard. Musically, songwriting-wise, all-wise. Even vocally, it was weak. Very, very weak. Until the second half came, it was pretty weak and ordinary. It was a lackluster Metallica that I heard. I don't know if I'm the only one who feels this way. It's definitely not like one. It's definitely not in the caliber of Master of Puppets.
Yeah, definitely the song. Not. Yeah.
It's not in the caliber of any of those songs. You know? This is a lackluster Metallica I heard.
It was different.
And the lyrics also are haywire. It's all
I
over
don't
the
know
place.
What happened in there.
It's all over the place. And coming up with the astronomy, a star. It was weird. The way it was written, it was quite different from what it is.
Yeah.
What Metallica usually writes like. Yeah. This was lackluster for me. And I'll be honest about it. It's pretty lackluster. I can see my earlier reactions where I've enjoyed it so much, and I'll see this one and I'll know. Just by my expressions while listening to it, I'll know that this wasn't the best pick of Metallica I've heard. And not even the best, anywhere near the best also.
Yeah.
It's nowhere near the best. Yeah. What are your thoughts?
Something was happening. I didn't get it. I really didn't get it with Susie and Carrie the nurse after that. I don't know what the concept of four wind bar is. I really don't know. So for me to understand what is happening, and then him saying astronomy, a star, I didn't quite get it. Though I would say on the contrary, I liked the beginning part of it. And I would have liked it to be the entire song like that.
Okay, a mellow, soft
version. Yeah, I wouldn't mind that actually.
Yeah, that would have been nice.
Yeah.
If it was only that.
Yeah.
But I still feel if the lyrics were not strong. Then
yeah, but you need much stronger lyrics for that kind of performance to pull off. Maybe the lyrics were falling short for them, so they thought of doing their usual stuff and give it a nice start to it and something unique, make something unique out of what they had at hand. Because this is, I guess, one and only song which I don't know where it is going of Metallica. Otherwise, the concepts are very, very clear. At least for us to listen.
I don't know what's wrong with this one.
Yeah.
It definitely doesn't seem to make complete sense on the first listen. Definitely. Maybe after it's written that way so that people hear it a few times and then they understand it from their perspective, their point of view. You know, there was a nurse, there was another girl.
There's
the four winds
Susie
bar.
Susie getting married.
Things happening after midnight and things. I just don't get it.
There are two doors.
There's a connection with the astronomy. I'm assuming there's a strong connection, but I didn't get it.
What they tried doing was created Matrix like a movie in the song. So on the first view or the first time watching the movie, people don't get
the next time
maybe things fall into place, because all of that door in front of the door, and that is the mirror image of the door and things like that. It actually reminded me of Matrix at that moment, because I was trying to understand what exactly is happening. Where is it trying to get at?
Metallica is definitely going through a tough phase right now? Their lead vocalist battling alcohol addiction. And we have reactors on this platform who actually promote alcohol at the same time. And they have also reacted to Metallica, which is kind of a travesty and a kind of ironic, you know, that this is how the world is. This is how the platform is. That on one side you have someone who's struggling with alcohol addiction, and because of that things are cancelled, things are not going well for the band. And for himself, I'm sure, in his personal life. And on the other hand, you have a reaction channel who openly sits there and promotes whiskey and says, ask you to drink along with them. So one side you have Metallica's lead vocalist battling that same whiskey, and on the other side you have reactors promoting the whiskey.
But isn't that against the YouTube community guidelines? Actually?
Apparently it isn't.
It should be.
Apparently it isn't.
No, I think community guidelines should be.
What is wrong in what they do?
I think promoting drinks or smoking both should be barred from public display at least.
public display. Yeah, yeah. That's right.
You're doing it in your personal life is
yeah.
okay.
When you're doing it yeah. on the camera and you're showing it to the yeah. world, that's what I find funny. Mm. I find it ironic that yeah. there is one side this guy is battling with it, mm. and because of it, the band is struggling and mm. suffering. Mm. And on the other hand, you have someone who's promoting the music and with a peg of alcohol yeah. in their hands. So it's funny. It's funny.
Okay.
And I don't think they are the only ones doing it.
A lot of, yeah.
They are other reactors I've seen in the past. Mm-hmm. And it makes it funny because, you know, what are you supposed to get? It's like this song. Mm-hmm. One way it's talking about astronomy, another way it's talking about two girls. What are you getting yeah. at? And the other side you're talking about them at Four Winds Bar, the rooms there, what is it? So it's like that, you know. Sometimes things mm-hmm. must be pretty simple. And perhaps this is that one song where I need to say it. Yeah. This Metallica has failed completely. Definitely. On the first listen, usually I get it right. I get an idea about what the song is about. I love the music too. Here's the first time I don't like the music. And I definitely don't like
the lyrics. Have reacted to Sanitarium as well as Frayed End. And both of them we got instantly. What was Frayed End?
Even if I didn't get it, Kirti usually gets
yeah,
it very well.
Yeah, but this one was...
So even if I don't get it, I'll say, okay, I don't get it because, yeah. you know, sometimes I'm that kind of a guy. I just don't get certain things and then I get some of the things which are the most difficult things for a human being yeah. to understand, I understand on the first go.
Right.
So that's the kind of guy I am. But Kirti usually gets it, as far as Metallica is concerned.
Metallica was...
And a few good. Other, many other bands and artists. Okay, anyway, enough time spent on this.
Yes.
Not a good song in my opinion. 1 on 10 if I have to rate it.
Thank you for watching. Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to Megadeth. We are going to react to the song How the Story Ends. And it is my first time single take on its reaction.
Mine as well. It's not a known song of Megadeth.
How
it's a surprising
ends.
Request by our patron Ajay.
Okay.
Not a known song. I wonder why it's put here.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, the first song was
first
quite disappointing.
One was also not
and this one is
common.
Not even heard, I think, in most of Asia and Africa. Where Megadeth is reasonably popular. They even came to Mumbai out of many countries in Asia Africa. So it's not that they're not heard of.
Mm-hmm.
So taking an unheard of song of theirs is quite strange. Let's get started.
Oh,
unheard song, at least for me and many other people in Asia and Africa, I'm sure. But what a song, what a song. This was tremendous. Tremendous. The lyrics sound very, very strong. It's talking about something very simple to get in comparison to the Metallica song we heard.
Yeah.
Very, very simple to understand this one. Kudos to the songwriter of this one. Phenomenal music though. The way it was sung, the way it was played, those guitars, whoa, and the drums banging. This was phenomenal music, really good to listen to. And coming after a lackluster song, lackluster metal song, this was outstanding.
This was outstanding.
This was completely makes you kind of forget the last song, and certainly will make me forget within a few seconds.
I like those highlight moments in the song. A guitar came just for a few seconds. It was like a teaser and then it went out. I wanted more of that. Why not? And then the drumming, the highlight moments for the drumming, I wanted more of that too. I don't know how much people like it or not, but I like those things done. Little bit, you know, teeny weeny things here and there in the music makes me very happy. I like the whole rhythm going on, but just to break it and put it something else here and there, make it more colorful, make it more vibrant, I appreciate that. It had to, if it was repeated a few more times, I wouldn't mind that. Yeah, I enjoyed the song. It's talking about side effects of war. These people are marching and approaching near, and how it's going to destroy the peace as well as the face of Earth.
Yeah, they're going to torch the whole town, the whole village, kill everyone, burn the houses down. And this is how the story
ends. And there
is
no way people can escape it, you know, I think.
That's basically what they're trying to say is war is not the answer.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you may think it is at times, but it isn't. Mm. So that's what they're saying in this song. Mm. That's what I understand it as. And it does give you a reality check, you know, how things can, you know, when you look at Japan till today, it's devastating the kind of destruction that happened to their country in World War II. Till today we watch a lot of programs from Japan on a channel called NHK World. So we know very well what is the situation of their cities. Till today you see those cities have not been able to recover. Complete cities, proper cities with a lot of structures, lot of homes, lot of companies, factories, godowns, all of them destroyed, and till today they are not able to recover. It's a sad situation. It gives you a real reality check about how dangerous war can be, you know. And I'm sure it's the same with other countries in the West who are on a day-to-day basis part of World War One and World War Two.
Also, Savi, not to forget what, you know, prior to that, Japan used to do in China. This is exactly the kind of scene may have been in China, people hiding, people, you know, like it or not, but they were going to be destroyed.
They attacked China in a very harsh manner.
Yeah, so there are many, many movies made on those stories, highlighting the plight of people at that
and
time.
Our best wishes are with the lead vocalist of Megadeth. He's battling cancer at the moment. Our best wishes from our channel and from us and our family and friends who like the music of Megadeth. Or even if you don't like, our best wishes to the lead vocalist and the band. I hope they find a way to keep the music alive that they've done so well for so long. Few decades now, almost 4 decades, maybe more, close to 4 decades I would imagine, of music. That's it for this one. We'll be back with another one. Goodbye.
Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to Deep Purple. We are going to react to the song Hard Loving Man, and it's a request of our patron Ajay.
Yeah, let's get started. Due to the duration of this reaction, we may not be able to go too deep into the song or the lyrics, even if we want to. We'll try to if it's that good. We'll definitely make time, but otherwise we'll be ending it very quickly, this one. Okay. Mostly about the listening. We'll be right back. the end was kind of annoying for me with a driller like sound. I liked the music in the rest of the song, but whenever this sound came like a driller, electric drill, it was annoying. It was annoying. Even what was done on the keyboards was a little bit annoying.
For me,
very annoying sound.
That didn't come out
then
right.
The rest of the music was pretty good. The drums and the guitar
the
were together.
The basic music that they played
was
music.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
And the lyrics were very ordinary. Limited, very ordinary. Limited and ordinary too. Nothing much really.
I think this was about a long jam session. That's all. It sounded like a practice session.
Just a practice session. Just to maybe fill up the album space.
Something or could be a song where people can just listen to it while doing other things. I don't know.
Can people really do other things with that annoying sound?
No, not
the end.
It's
annoying.
You can't keep it loud, kind of loud as well.
Irritating sound.
If you're listening to on the stage,
it totally ruined the experience for me. It totally. That ending sound totally ruined it for me. And I can't believe I'm saying that for Deep Purple. Deep Purple is pretty much known, and I've heard them live twice in Mumbai. So fortunately they didn't play this live.
I'd left
if they played it. The second time I was not that interested.
But this is like a filler music.
Yeah.
When every vocalist is, taking a rest or something, and some other members are also.
I think all were part of it. All of them were part of it.
Exactly.
In fact, they may have bought someone extra to do that
guitar
sound, which is so irritating.
Okay.
So it was no break for anybody. Definitely time for the audience to take a break. When you hear something like that, it's best to take your break at that time.
Yeah, you can go grab a snack and all that. Yeah. The music is playing.
Yeah, music is playing. Don't care too much. Annoying. Didn't you find it annoying?
I didn't like the keyboard as well as this.
Annoying though, or just you didn't like it?
Didn't like it. I would say annoying. For that, you have to really annoy me.
Okay. That's well said.
Yeah.
That's it for this one. I don't think much to say about song like that. Really.